Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Nutrition in animals. Okay, and up till now we have discussed about the how the food get digested in the human being, or we have discussed about digestion in humans. Okay, so there are the several digestive organs included in the digestion process, and there are the different processes are going on in the digestion process. Okay, so today we will move for the next point, which is somehow also related to our digestive system, that we will discuss about what? Diarrhea. What is mean by diarrhea? Okay, so sometime what happen, the watery stool get passed out through the anus. Okay, the watery stool get passed out through the anus, and that condition it is called as what? Diarrhea. Okay, so that condition it is called as diarrhea. What is mean by diarrhea? When the person is suffering from the watery stool or from the anus, when the watery stool is coming out, then that person might be get suffers from what? Diarrhea. Okay, so it is very common in the small children also, and sometimes it can happen in an adult person also. And in India, it is very frequently happen, or most of the people are suffering from the diarrhea. Okay, and during the diarrhea, what happened? We are telling that watery stool get passed out from the body. It means what happened? The more amount of the water can get lost from the body. Okay, but to avoid the loss of the body or to retain the water in the body, the person, those who are suffering from the diarrhea, that person or that patient should take the ORS solution. Now ORS means what? Oral rehydration solution. Okay, oral rehydration solution means what? Rehydration means what happened? Because of this solution, again the water gets to our body gets again water. That is only what? Rehydration. Hydra means what? Water. Okay, so oral rehydration solution. This oral rehydration solution you can easily get in the medical shop, or this ORS solution we can make at a home also. You have to take the 1 liter of water, you have to boil it properly, and in that you have to add the 4 spoon of sugar and 1 spoon of salt. Okay, and that ORS solution that person should take frequently or time to time to reduce the loss of the water and to again get the water to the body. ORS solution is very important. Okay, so this is about what? Diarrhea. Okay, so up till now we have discussed about the human digestion system, but like human digestion system, there are the certain other organisms are also there, and that organisms also require the food. As we know, all the living things require the food. It is a one of the characteristics of a living thing. Okay, but like the human being, not all the organisms are having well developed digestive system. Okay, so let's discuss about the one amazing fact which is related to what? Starfish. Okay, so the starfish doesn't have the proper digestive system like that human beings having. Okay, so how they are taking the food, how they are digesting the food? So this starfish, mostly what is the food of the starfish? Starfish is having the animals which are having the shell. Okay, starfish can feed on the animals, those who are having the cover on its body, and that cover is rich in what? Calcium carbonate. So when the starfish feels that animal is near to eat, then what happens? That starfish pop its stomach through the mouth. Okay, the starfish pop means it with that animals get cover with the stomach of a starfish. Okay, pop means what? Suddenly comes out. Okay, so the stomach of the starfish suddenly comes out from its mouth, and they engulf that animal. Engulf means what? They takes that animals with the help of that pop out stomach, and then they started to digest that animals with the help of the different enzymes which are present in the starfish body. Okay, okay, so somehow like this structure starfish is having. So this starfish engulf its stomach, pop out its stomach from its mouth, through its mouth. Pop out means what? Suddenly comes out. Okay, so from its mouth the stomach comes out, and with the help of that stomach the food enters into the body, and with the help of the different digestive enzymes the food can get digested. Okay, so this is about the starfish, how the starfish is having their food. Okay, Now, today we will move for the next point, and which is very important also, that is what digestion in grass-eating animals. How the grass-eating animals are digesting their food. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so let's discuss about the digestion in grass-eating animals. So, the grass-eating animals like cow, buffalo, goat, rabbit, deer, okay, all these are what the grass eating animals, okay. So if you have seen that whenever these animals are getting the grass, they are taking that grass hurriedly, okay, or they are eating that grass hurriedly. Why? For that also reason is there, because the herbivorous animals are the food for carnivorous, okay. So to protect themselves from the carnivorous animal, they are eating very rapidly, or they are taking the food or the grass very rapidly inside, and whenever they are having the free time or whenever they goes to the safe place, again they bring back that food into their mouth and started to chew it, okay. And that process is only called as what? Rumination. And that animals are called as what? Ruminant. Okay. So whenever the herbivores are getting the grass, they started to eat very rapidly. And whenever they are having that grass, it gets mixed into the saliva and they chew it. Okay. First it goes into their rumen. Okay. It goes first into their rumen. Okay. But whenever they are having the time, or after certain period of the time, what happens? These animals bring back the food into their mouth, and that time what happened? They started to chew it way again and again. Okay. So that time they started to chew it very properly, and that process is called as what? Rumination. Okay. That process is called as rumination. What is mean by rumination? The herbivorous animals bring back whatever the food they had eaten, that food they bring back into their mouth and they started to chew it again, and that process is called as what? Rumination. And the animals, those who are showing that rumination process, that animals are called as what? Ruminant animals. Okay, that animals are called as ruminant animals. Okay. Okay, so what happened? Whenever the herbivorous animals are having the green grass, they are having it, and that green grass, the whatever the grass they have eaten, they first it comes into what? Rumen. Okay. So now let's discuss about how the digestion in ruminants happen. Okay. So basically the stomach of the ruminants are divided into four chambers. Okay. So the stomach of the ruminants are divided into four chambers, that is what? Rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. Okay, so these are the four chambers of the ruminant. Here first we have discussed about the rumen. What happens in the rumen? Whenever the herbivores are having the grass, they eat it quickly, it mix into the saliva and they chew it. Okay, then that chew or that mixed food, the food, whatever the grass which is mixed into the saliva, it goes into the first chamber of the stomach, that is nothing but what? Rumen. And in the rumen, the grass is get partially digested, which is called as what? Curd. Okay, which is called as what? Curd. Okay, so this is about what? Rumen. So after the rumen, what happen? After the rumen, the food is get transported to the second chamber of the stomach, which is called as what? Reticulum. Okay, which is called as what? Reticulum. And from the reticulum, the food comes back into the mouth. Okay, the food comes back into the mouth for the further thorough chewing. Okay, so from the rumen, the food enters into the reticulum, and from the reticulum, the food comes back into the mouth of an animal for the thorough chewing. Okay, whenever the thorough chewing is happens or the completed, then they swallows the food, then the ruminant swallows the food, and then it enters into the third chamber of the stomach, and the smallest chamber of the stomach, that is what? Omasum. Okay, so see, this omasum is the smallest chamber, while the rumen is the largest chamber. Okay, the rumen is the largest chamber of the ruminant stomach, and the omasum is the smallest chamber of ruminant stomach. Okay, so up till now we have seen here what? Omasum. Okay, so after this
It comes into the third chamber, that is omasum, and in the omasum the food is get broken down into the small pieces. Okay, the food can get broken down into the small pieces, and after that it comes into the large chamber of the stomach, that is nothing but what? Obesum. Okay, so that obesum contain the different types of the gastric juices. It also contain the hydrochloric acid, and also it contain the certain bacteria which helps to digest the grass. Okay, which helps to digest the grass. So in the obesum, what happen? The food get digested, and from there the digested food is get transported to the different body parts, and whatever the undigested food is there, it get throw out from the body with the help of the anus. So this is all about what? The rumination in the animals, or the digestion in the ruminants animals. Okay, so see, the stomach is having four chambers, that is rumen, reticulum, omasum and the abomasum, and these four chambers togetherly called as what? Compound stomach. These four chambers togetherly called as what? Compound stomach. Okay, the food of the herbivorous is what? Green grass, and that green grass is rich in what? Cellulose, that is nothing but what? One type of a carbohydrate. Okay, so that cellulose or the green grass can get digested by only animals or by only herbivorous animals. Why it is so? Because in that animals there are the certain bacteria which are present in their digestive system, and that is the reason with the help of that bacteria they can easily digest the cellulose. Okay, and that same bacteria are absent in the human body or in the other animals also, and that is the reason we cannot digest the grass. Okay, so that is the reason how they are grass eating animals can easily digest the grass which is rich in the cellulose, because they are having the certain types of the bacteria which helps to digest the cellulose. Okay, also there are the certain animals like that, we can say that horse and rabbits are there, that animals are having the large sac like structure between the esophagus and the small intestine. Okay, between the esophagus and the small intestine they are having the large sac like structure, and that large sac like structure is called as what? Caecum. Okay, that large sac like structure is called as caecum. In that caecum certain bacteria are present which helps to digest the cellulose. Which bacteria are absent in the human being? That's why the human being cannot digest the cellulose. Okay, so this is all about the digestion in grass eating animals. Okay, so whenever they are having the grass, they eat it, that first goes into the rumen. Here the grass get partially digested, which is called as what? Cut. Whenever the animals get the time, they bring back that partially digested food into their mouth and started to chew it again. That process is called as rumination. And that animals are called as what? Ruminants. Okay, ruminants having four chambers of the stomach, that is rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum, and together it is called as what? Compound stomach. Okay, so this is all about the digestion in ruminants. Okay, so it is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.